Today we want to start a very good, wonderful service, and this service is on the Holy Spirit. Okay, we dedicate one Sunday now just to for the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, Holy Ghost service. We dedicate this every one Sunday in a month. Amen.
Amen.
And then we dedicate it to Holy Spirit, to know about the Holy Spirit, to study about the Holy Spirit, to understand more about the Holy Spirit. Because the Bible says, my people perish for lack of knowledge. My people perish for lack of knowledge. So when we have knowledge of the Holy Spirit, we have the knowledge of what He do. We have the knowledge of who the Holy Spirit is, how He started, and what He do in our life. What is the role of the Holy Spirit in our life? The role of God the Father in our life, the role of God the Son in our life, the role of God the Holy Spirit in our life. How is this three, you know, working together to make us whom we are in the Lord? So this is what we want to do. We want to study more about the Holy Spirit. We pray for the Holy Spirit. We pray more about the Spirit of God and the Spirit of God and the Spirit of God. But now we want to study more and know more about the Holy Spirit, the work of the Holy Spirit, how the Holy Spirit, work in our life and in everything that we do. Amen.
Amen.
So that is why we want to go into this the Holy Spirit. And once every month, 1 week, we go into a little bit deep details. So today I have a message on the Holy Spirit, and I said this message is the presence of the Spirit. The presence of the Spirit of God. The presence of the Spirit of God. You know, sometimes when we are praying, we don't know what is happening to us, and we don't know when Jesus is speaking to us, or God is speaking to us, or the Spirit is speaking to us. We don't know the voice we hear. We don't understand how the Holy Spirit work and how the three connect together and work in our life, and what the Spirit of God do and what the Spirit of God do not. That is a work of God the Father. That is a work of God the Son. That is a work of God the Spirit. But these three agree in one, and they are one because they are fed from the same river. Amen?
Amen.
So they are one and not three, but one. So I will start from Genesis chapter 1, from verse 1 and 2, from the beginning. The Bible says, from the beginning God made the whole earth was without form. It was without form. And it is like the whole earth was without form, and the water filled the whole earth. I would say, in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth, and the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the earth. And then the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. So the presence of the Spirit of God was from the beginning. It was there. It was the presence of the Spirit of God was there from the beginning. It says, the earth was without form. There is no formation. There is no form. There is no land. There is no firmament. You know, there's no tree. There is no animals. There's nothing. There's no light. There's no moon. There's no star. Nothing. That's nothing. The earth was without form. So if anybody is trying to know the beginning of the earth, that person is swimming into a deep ocean that he can never ever get to the bottom of it. Nobody can be able.
Can swim without.
Yeah, absolutely. The word of God says it is past founding. It is past founding. When you want to start to study how the earth, or want to know how the earth and how the beginning, what is the beginning, how the beginning comes, how God formed the world and this and that, that means that you are going into a deep pit that you cannot be able to reach, to a bottomless pit anyway. Amen?
Amen.
And that is why God was asking Job, where are you when I made the heaven and the earth? Where are you when I formed the earth? Where are you when I stationed the moon and the stars? Where are you? You know, if you say you are wise, you should be there. You should be there from the beginning. Amen?
Amen.
You should be there from the beginning. So where have you been? So the presence of God, the presence of the Holy Ghost was there. And then the same Job chapter 33 from verse 4 says, the Spirit of God has made me, and the breath of the Almighty give me life. It says, and the Spirit of God The Spirit of God has made me. Remember, Job is a friend of God. Job is very close to God because he was the righteous man. And God recognized that. So when you are righteous, oh, glory to God. You know, I was praying and the Spirit of God gave me an inspiration. Okay? And I want us to understand this inspiration. Look, when you are righteous, yes, God will come to you. When you are righteous, God will come and do what? Come and visit you. Amen?
Amen.
When you are close to God, God will come and visit you. Remember, when Adam and Eve was close to God, they don't need to call God to come. God scheduled a time to go and visit them. Yes?
Yes.
God will always go and visit them and make them to be his friend. And they will say, what a friend we have in Jesus. All my sins and sorrow bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. So what a friend we have in Jesus. What a friend we have in God. So, I tell you, man is God's best friend.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Man is God's best friend.
Amen.
So when you are living a good life and a righteous life, when you are doing your best, I tell you, you become God's best friend. He will come to you and he will talk to you. He will speak to you. Amen.
Amen.
He will visit you. He will talk to you. He will speak. I remember in Nigeria that time, you know, we don't have a lot of this. I'm not used to this, what's it called again? This clock, time alarm. So all I do is when I go to bed, I say, God, wake me up by 10 o'clock. Wake me up by 8 o'clock. Wake me up by 9 o'clock. By that 9 o'clock, I will hear a knock. God will come and wake me up. Amen.
Yeah.
It won't miss 1 second.
Who is alive?
By that 9 o'clock, imagine this thing is 1994. By that time, God will just come and wake me up. Say, wake up. Touch me like that. Or knock. Amen.
Amen.
Wake me up. So when you are close to God, you can tell. I remember sometime my wife would go to work. My wife said the same thing to me when I told my wife this, and then she put it in practice and it was working for you, isn't it,
Mom?
Yeah, and you too. Fantastic. So try that. You will see God is so close. To God is the best friend of a man, of you, and of me. God is our best friend. And that is why he made us in his own image and likeness. And he made us in his own image and likeness and breathed life into us and live in us from the beginning. The Spirit was put into us. And that Spirit that is put into us is the connection between us and God. Amen?
Amen.
That Spirit, remember, the Spirit is not the soul, okay? The soul of a man is different from the Spirit, and the Spirit is different from the body. So the Spirit is a connection between God and man that we relate to God and man, okay? So, and that is why Job said in Job chapter 33 from verse 4, it says, the Spirit of God has made me, and the breath of the Almighty give me life. So one thing that the Spirit of God do for you is to give you what? Life. Amen?
Amen.
And the Bible says that Jesus came to give us life, and life in abundance. And this life is through the Spirit of God. Remember, Jesus Christ came to teach, and after he teaches, he said to his disciples, look, you will not understand this right now. I'm going to send you a helper who is called the Spirit. I will send you the Spirit. When I go, I will send you the helper. I will send you the Spirit to come and teach you and guide you. That means the Spirit of God have got its own special work in our life, and that is what we want to, you know, go into the deep, to the depth of what is the work of the Spirit of God. What is the presence? What will happen to us? And then we'll feel. Sometimes we'll feel, I say, I can feel God. I can feel Jesus. I can feel His presence. What presence? Who is there? Which one? Which one is there? How did it come? Is it come? Is it God the Father? Is it God the Son? Is it God the Spirit? So it's good that we understand this. The three is one. Never ever miss it. But God the Father, God the Son, God the Son, they've got their special duties. Amen? Amen. And they agree in one accord. And that's what the Bible says. When we are united, we can stand, and the enemy can never ever break through us. It is only when we start to disagree with ourselves and start to, you know, quarrel with ourselves that the enemy can be able to break through us. Amen?
Amen.
So the Trinity agrees. The Spirit of God is gives life to us. And that Jesus said, you have life. I come that you have life and have that life, that have life in abundance. Jesus come, when he finished, he gave life. He gave life to us, give life to your mortal body. Amen. And then if we go down, okay, let us get that in our mind, one. And then secondly, if you go to 2 Corinthians chapter 3 from verse 17, you say, now the Lord is the Spirit. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is what? Freedom. What gives us freedom is where the Spirit of God is activated. Where the Spirit of God is working, we have what? Freedom. Amen. Amen. So we have freedom where the Spirit of God is. So once the Spirit of God is here, we have our freedom. We can be able to float in the Spirit. We can be able to be happy in the Spirit, because that is life, that is joy, that's one song that says, in the presence of God, there is joy in my Father's house. Hallelujah, joy in my Father's house. There is joy in my Father's house. Hallelujah, joy. Hallelujah, joy. Hallelujah, joy. Hallelujah, joy. In my Father's house, that is a spirit, that's a presence that is there. When we walk into this place, sometimes you walk into a place, you feel a goosebump. Yeah? You walk into a fellowship, or when we are praying, you feel something in your body. That thing you feel is the presence of the Spirit of God. Amen?
Amen.
That is the freedom. That is the freedom that is there. The Bible says, in the presence of God, that is freedom, wonderful freedom. So the Spirit of God is that gives us freedom, that makes us to be free. We are no longer slaves, but we are free people. Amen?
Amen.
Okay. If we go to Timothy chapter 1 from verse 7, it says, For God give us a spirit, not the spirit of fear, but the spirit of boldness.
Yes.
So whenever you go out there to preach the good news and somebody challenge you, and then you stand by your feet and said, no, you cannot shut me down. I will continue to preach the good news. I'm not scared of you. I will continue to preach the good news. And you see, it is the Spirit of God that gives you that word, boldness. Amen?
Amen.
But when the Spirit of God is not really activated and working in you, when you must tear up that Spirit of God, you're gonna be scared. You're gonna be afraid. Whenever you are sleeping at home, and then you start to feel scared, just pray and say, let the Spirit of God come and take control. Amen?
Amen.
So when the Spirit of God is there, it's in your life, it's in your room, it's in your house, there is no fear. Every fear is gone. Every fear is what?
Gone.
Amen?
Amen.
Okay. Another work that the Spirit of God will help us, when we're going to feel that presence of the Spirit of God, is in Zechariah chapter 4 from verse 6, and it says, from verse 6, 7, 8, and 9, it says, this is the word of the Lord to Zerubbabel. It said, not by power, not by might, but by my Spirit. It says, not by power, not by might, but by my Spirit. And then when you have that Spirit of God, you can be able to make every mountain to flee. Amen?
Amen.
Every mountain shall become leveled. What level that mountain? The power of the Spirit of God. Amen?
Amen.
Okay. And then if we go down again, the Bible says, the Spirit of the living God, if you go to verse 9 of the Holy Spirit, the finisher. You see, the Bible says, God starts a work and then He will finish it.
Mm.
Yeah? When God starts a work, He gives it to the Spirit of God to finish it. So the Spirit of God is the finisher. God began the creation. Okay? God had it in mind to create the world. Then He sent the Spirit to go and finish the work of the creation. And that is why God, Jesus, after Jesus, then He sent the Spirit of God to stay, to live with us, and to finish until the work is done. Amen?
Amen.
The Spirit of God is the finisher until the work is done. So the Spirit of God doesn't leave until when we all gonna go to the kingdom of God. It doesn't leave us. It doesn't stop until when we are all going to go to the kingdom of God. So the Spirit of God is the finisher. Okay. Let us understand this again. The Bible says Jesus Christ came to save us and to set us free. He died for us, yes?
Yes.
But the work is not done. The work is not finished. When He died and then He was buried, the work is not done. Because the Bible says, without resurrection, our faith is in vain. Amen?
Amen?
Without Jesus Christ resurrecting from the dead, then we have no hope and our faith is in vain. So what then raised Jesus Christ from the dead? The Bible says in Romans chapter 8 from verse 11, it says, the Holy Spirit was present, okay, during the resurrection. It says, If that spirit, the Holy Spirit that raised Christ from the dead, if He lives in you, that same Spirit will also quicken your mortal bodies. So the Holy Spirit is the finisher. Jesus died for us on the cross of Calvary and was buried. And then the Spirit of the Lord on the third day raised Him up, finished the work of salvation. So the Holy Spirit of God is the finisher. When you are building a house, after the builders have come and build, do this, do that, do whatever, put the foundation, and the architect will draw the house, give it over to the builders come and build and do everything. Before you pack into your house, there will be the people that are called finishers. They will come, every details. They will paint it, they will touch everywhere, check whether the door is closing, and whatever, they are called the finishers. They will come, they will finish, they will go through everything, set everything on before you moved into the house. Amen?
Amen.
I have heard that language several times used by the people that work for me. It says, when they have a big contract, when they finish, they say, I will send the finisher to come and finish up the work. Amen?
Amen.
And the finisher will come. So if you better be good with the finisher. Because if you're not good with the finisher, the work is gonna look, it's not gonna look nice. So you're gonna be good with the finisher, you're gonna be nice to the finisher, and the finisher will touch this, touch that.
Make it smooth.
Make it smooth, make it look nice, so that when you come in, then the place will look very nice. Amen?
Amen.
So the Holy Spirit is the finisher. Amen?
Amen.
Without the Holy Spirit, the work will look rough. But when the Holy Spirit come into your life, come into your family, come into your spirit, it will finish, it will smooth everything. So Holy Spirit is the finisher. Amen?
Amen.
And just as we've had, the Holy Spirit is our helper. He helps us, He teach us. Okay, let's just take for instance, again, another good example that the Holy Spirit is the finisher. Jesus Christ bring the word to the disciples. The word is there, but they cannot understand it. They haven't got the understanding. Until when He go, then He sent the Holy Spirit to come and finish that work.
Smooth job.
Smooth it. Amen?
Amen.
So the Holy Spirit is the finisher. Amen?
Amen.
Our God is a good God.
Amen?
Amen? Okay, I want to summarize here. I want to touch the last three things that the Holy Spirit do. This is just pointing them out. We're going to go into the full details of them. In John chapter 16 from verse 13, it says, when the spirit of truth, whatever you are saying, the truth is the spirit of God.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. You say the truth, you are walking with the spirit of God. And then when you say lies, it is devil. Amen.
Amen.
See, when the spirit of truth, that is the spirit of God, he will guide you. He will guide you. Amen.
Amen.
Remember when Moses was going, he said, God, if you're not in this journey, I'm not going to go. And God says, I'm going to send my presence with you. I'm going to send my spirit with you to go and smooth and finish the work. Amen?
Amen.
So he will guide you and he guide you unto all the truths. He will guide you unto all the truth. And then if you go down, read it down, it says, and he will declare to you the things that are to come. The Holy Spirit will declare to you the things that are to come. So, the vision you receive comes by the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. So, he will declare to you the things that are to come. So, when you receive vision, oh, I see a vision. The Holy Spirit is opening your eyes to see what's ahead of you. Amen.
Amen.
And when Jesus Christ was praying, he saw the vision. The Holy Spirit opened his eye to see what's ahead of him.
GPS.
Amen. Praise God. So the Spirit of God opened our eyes and then he showed us the vision. He showed us what's ahead of us. So I want to summarize here. Number one, Holy Spirit is present from the beginning. And one of the good points I can say today for us to understand so much about the Spirit of God is the Holy Spirit is the great finisher. He finishes the work. He finishes the job. Whatever job God has started, creating the world, whatever Jesus Christ has started, saving our soul, the Holy Spirit do what? Finishes.
Get the job done.
Yeah, he get it done. Then when he finish the work of the creation, then he start to guide us toward that very work that he finishes. He said, this is what I have done. This is where I have placed this. This is where I have placed that. This is what's ahead of you. Amen?
Amen.
So the Holy Spirit will come and guide us, will come and direct us, and the Holy Spirit will do what? Will declare to us the things that are to come. You want to pray for vision? You want to pray for dreams? Holy Spirit will give it to you. The Spirit of God will give you vision, and the Spirit of God will guide you into the future. Amen?
Amen.
Our God is good.
Amen.
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 So let us always, you know, desire that very work and exploit that very presence of the Spirit of God. So brethren, I want us to understand that the Spirit of God is present everywhere, every step of your life. The Spirit of God is there to finish it up, to lead you as you go, and to bring you back. The Holy Spirit is a great finisher. And may God bless his word in our heart. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
And amen. And amen. Amen.